tonight. This should be a good matchup.
Now we're going to honor our country of America.
Let's take that.
Let's just back until it's so send the card.
Sir,
I'm Jenna Criscola.
I'm Kevin Semeca, and welcome to Cody Arena in West Orange, New Jersey. As you can see, the Mount Olive and Livingston Television programs have teamed up to produce the first cross-district van production. Now, while they're here to cover the varsity hockey game between Mount Olive and Livingston, we're here to give you the inside scoop of what happens behind the scenes.
We're giving you a behind-the-scenes look at what goes into a van production and how Mount Olive and Livingston students work together to make this project happen.
But first, let's see what the teachers have to say about how this collaboration started.
I'm here with Mr. Milano, the Livingston High School teacher, TV teacher, as well as Mr. Pramble, the Mount Olive TV teacher. So how did you two become familiar with each other?
Well, actually, when I was in high school, Mr. Milano was my television production teacher, and he's the reason why I'm teaching you guys today.
Now, how did this joint program get started in the first place?
Well, ever since Mr. Pramble started teaching at Mount Olive, we've kept in contact professionally, and we've always talked about wanting to do something jointly with the two groups of students together. And we finally got an opportunity here because our two teams were playing against each other, and it seemed like the perfect time to team up our production squads.
Now, what did you take from your Livingston High School teachings from Mr. Milano, and what did you apply to your Mount Olive teaching?
Well, pretty much the entire Mount Olive structure is based off of how Livingston is structured. From the Meet the Crew shows that we do to how TV1 tiers up to TV4. So, I mean, all the whole basis is right out of his playbook.
Now, how will this show be recorded tonight?
Well, Livingston's been very fortunate. Over the years, through donations and grants, we've managed to put together a remote TV production truck. Very lucky to have it, and it's something that Mr. Pramble was trained on when he was a student. We've always talked about how we could make this project happen, so we're going to use that truck today. We've trained the Mount Olive students to work with the Livingston students, and in a way where they're going to learn that everything they've learned is universal, they're going to work together to record this show, and then we'll air it on both stations.
Now let's take a look at how the students feel about how the show is being recorded. I'm here with Alyssa Nachampkin and Tyler Peach, two students from Mount Olive High School. So guys, what are your positions tonight?
Well, I'm behind the scenes camera number one for tonight.
I get to be camera one tonight during the third period.
Now how exactly do these positions work?
Well, when you're behind the scenes camera, I'm getting interviews, like our camera person is doing right now. And just basically getting shots of things that are going on with the crew.
The way it works is we're going to have a three-camera shoot on the actual game, and camera one is basically the shot that doesn't zoom in much. It pretty much just pans left to right and follows the game.
Now, do you do anything to, like, get ready for this position?
I guess to prepare for that position, you just have to see where the action is, kind of. Well, the behind-the-scenes action, not what's actually going on in the game. So, follow the action. That's it.
I watched the person doing the camera for period one kind of set up, and I kind of got a feel for using the kind of camera. And for the actual game itself, it's really just got to pay attention to the game and follow the puck.
All right, thanks very much, guys.
Thanks.
I'm here with Tom Forkin and Will Powells from Livingston High School. So, what are your positions for tonight?
Technical director.
I am the character generator.
Now, how exactly do these positions work?
So, basically, I listen to the director, and he cues me when to put what camera shots on, and I also put in titles, DSKs, which is a downstream key. So I'll put in the score or the opening graphics.
Well, I create the title. I give you guys the credits, and I tell you, basically what the score is throughout the game.
Now, what kind of work goes into these positions tonight?
Well, not really just this position, all positions in general. You set up in the beginning, get an idea where the camera shots are. You talk to all your crew members, the director, and have a good idea what's going to go on right before.
Basically, before the game, I have to like make sure that everything's set up, like all the credits and everything's typed up. And during the game, I have to like update the score to let the viewer know what the score is. Yeah.
And one last question. What do you hope to get out of this experience tonight?
Well, all this experience is good. Hands-on practice, what you need for in the real world. This is the best you can get.
Well, I mean, I have a lot of fun doing this. I like the people I do it with. And who knows, I might do something with it in the real world.
All right, thank you so much, guys.
No problem, Kip.
I'm here with Jen Veglis from Mount Olive High School. So, Jen, what's your crew position for tonight?
I'm camera 2, B-roll, and I'm also audio.
Now, how do these positions work exactly?
Okay, well, B-roll is behind the scenes, so I take B-roll of the cameras, actually, so it's kind of a behind the scenes of a behind the scenes.
So what kind of work goes into these crew positions?
You have to be on top of everything. You have to pay attention to what everyone else is doing so you can catch the shots and make it look good.
And what do you expect to gain from this experience tonight?
I expect to gain a lot of more knowledge about using the camera and also the type of audio that is used in these kind of productions.
All right, thanks so much, Jen. I'm here with David Strumeyer, another student from Livingston High School. So, Dave, what's your position for tonight?
Tonight I'll be directing the third period.
How does this position work?
Mainly I tell cameramen what shot I want to see and tell the technical director what shot to put on the air.
Now, what kind of work goes into this position?
Mainly being able to communicate and know like everything that's going on, what everyone has to do, and back them up if they need help.
And what do you hope to learn from this experience?
Becoming a better leader, mainly. My mom always told me be a leader, not a follower, so it's helping.
All right, thanks so much, Dave.
Thank you.
We're about halfway through the game right now, and the score is 1-0 with the Mount Olive Marauders in the lead. But no matter what the score is, we're still hard at work, bringing you the coverage of the game and the behind-the-scenes look of how the production is made. The second period crew is hard at work now with Kayla Calderwood in the director's chair. And the first period crew is now finished, and let's get a glimpse of what they thought of how the first period went. I'm here with Zach Yukis, a student at Mount Olive High School who just finished his job during first period. So Zach, what was your crew position in first period?
My crew position for first period was audio.
How does this position work?
You gotta keep the audio levels leveled so you can hear the background of the game, but you also want to hear the announcers announcing the game where they're not peaking, and you want to keep their audio levels down, but you also want to hear the background music, like of the game playing of the hockey game.
Now, what kind of work goes into this crew position?
The amount of work is you have to make sure the audio levels are off. So before the game actually started, when we were figuring out what was going on, we saw the audio levels on the meter. And if they were peaking in red, you want them to be down in green or right at yellow. And if they're in between that sweet spot, then you know you got good audio.
Now, what did you learn from this experience?
From learning in the bus, there's a lot going on. But as long as you focus on your job and you make sure everything's going and you're keeping track of the game and you're listening to the audio, everything goes smoothly and it's a lot of fun.
All right, thanks so much, Zach.
You're welcome.
Now we're going to check out what happens in the van. Let's go.
Ryan Shakespeare's second goal tonight.
Score
and
for the game,
Jenna? Now 2-1 lead. That was straight up.
Are you ready?
There.
It's now Mount Olive 2, Livingston 1.
Insane. Sidney Crosby, take notes, sir.
Camera 1, get a center shot.
That was sick.
Like that. Are you ready, Jenna?
Yeah. Oh,
okay, you ready? DSKN? DSKN? Good. 5, 4, 3. DSK out. Well, that's
now,
number 2.
Face off one by Mount Olive. Let's take it by Livingston right here. Ooh! Nice hit right there.
Let's take one.
It's now period 3, and I just got back from working graphics. My co-host, Kevin, is now working the behind-the-scenes camera. So, Kevin.
Oh, hey.
How's it going so far?
Not too bad. Just getting B-roll from all the different crew positions going on. It's a lot of fun. Couldn't ask for anything better to do on my Saturday night. Very nice. All right. I'm really sorry, but I got to get back to work. So have fun. I'll see you later.
All right. Let's see what else is going on in period three. So I'm here with Josh. Now, Josh, what was your crew position?
I was the first period director.
And how do you feel with working with Mount Olive?
I thought it was a great experience. I thought it was really good to get to work with a different crew of people besides the people we normally get to work with. It was good to sort of see that there are other people in other towns that have a lot of experience in television and can put on a production. It was just fun. A lot of people running around enjoying making television.
I'm with Jen Shanga from Mount Olive. So what was your crew position?
My crew position was technical director. And now in this crew position, I switch between the camera shots that you see on the screen.
And how do you feel with working with Livingston High School?
It was amazing. As a van production, it was completely different from a studio production. And it was a great experience.
And what did you learn from this experience?
Never having done a van production before, I learned all the aspects of it, what it takes to make it actually happen, and it was an amazing experience. I loved it.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Well, the game is over, and the Mount Olive Marauders win the game with a final score of 3-2. But our job's not over yet. We made a mess, so we have to clean it up. As you can see, camera 2 behind us is being broken down. And now, let's take it to the teachers and see how the production went. I'm here to wrap things up with Mr. Milano and Mr. Pramel. So, how do you think the production went overall?
Well, I think the production went very well. The kids were well-behaved, everyone was on their crew positions, doing what they needed to do. The collaboration and the help that the Livingston kids were given to the Mount Olive and the announcing by both announcers was a good job. The game went well, the production went well. Definitely looking forward to this in the future.
Now about van productions in general, how often do these take place?
Well, Livingston, we try to make it a weekly thing. We try to cover every varsity sport. Sometimes we'll skip a week with nothing covered, but sometimes we'll have a week where two things are covered. So it's a fairly regular thing that we do with our class.
Do you believe joint programs between Livingston and Mount Olive will continue?
Absolutely. I think tonight was a great success. I think both teams learned from each other and everybody watching the other side and saying, wow, we should do something like that. A lot of mutual admiration. And I think that's what we were hoping for. I don't know if we'll get too many more field productions in because unfortunately our two towns don't play each other very often, but we've definitely got some ideas in the works for other things that we can do, whether they're on location or in the studio.
Now, what kinds of ideas might those be?
It's hard to say. You know, we've talked about studio productions either that both our towns are involved in, or even if not, if we come up with an event where it just needs a bigger crew, we just decide to work together and it's irrelevant as to whose event it is, we may be able to do something like that.
All right, thank you both very much.
So clearly this van production and behind-the-scenes shoot was a great success.
And everybody had a blast doing it.
At Cody Arena, I'm Jenna Criscola.
And I'm Kevin Semeca from MOTV. Thanks for staying with us.
And have a good one.
With me to the distant shore, we won't hesitate. Break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today. Life is a highway. I will ride it all night long. If you're going my way, I want to drive it all night long. Through all these cities and all these towns, it's in my blood and it's all around. I loved you now like I loved you then. This is the road.
Maybe these teams will meet up again in the state playoffs if things
go
well. We can do another joint conjunction, join a TV group. And really has been a pleasure. Shouts out to both crews, Mount Olive and Livingston. Not really Brandon Melvin, just kidding, Brandon Melvin. And Lance fans going home unhappy, of course. Mount Olive, they have a nice bus ride home. They are pumped up.
They're going to have a party on that
bus. They're happy. They're going back to the state playoffs. And you know what? It has been a MOTV and an LTV production.
February 11th.
I'm Jesse Francione.
I'm Matt McNamara.
And it has been a pleasure, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see you next time. Thank you.